Welcome to the Spirit of Life channel. This message begin right now. A golden opportunity. Beloved masters, the earth and humanity are on the verge of the greatest awakening and transformation since the fall of consciousness into the density of the lower realms. It may seem as though the elements are out of control and destruction abounds on earth. However, we ask you to please remember, out of chaos comes new creation. Many dear souls who are not yet ready to graduate from the wheel of reincarnation and karma are transcending into the higher realms in preparation for an upgrade in consciousness as they prepare for a new and better cycle of experience in the physical/material worlds of expression. As we have told you before, because of what you, the legions of light, have accomplished, it is assured that no other group of souls will ever have to experience the deep level of suffering, fear, negativity, and deprivation that you have experienced during your many sojourns in this galaxy and especially on Earth. The beautiful servants of the Creator, the Devic and Elemental Kingdoms, have been given another new directive, instructions to begin to infuse the Earth in full force with their elements of life, cosmic fire, the life force of creation, the breath of the Supreme Creator, the air element, the cleansing and life-sustaining element of water, and the foundation of your existence on the material plane, the element of earth. You may see the changing and erratic weather patterns and shifting earth as destructive forces of nature, but we see it as a necessary process to bring your earth back into health and balance. The elements are not your enemies, they are divine gifts from the Creator, but you have misused and abused the earth and yourselves long enough. Humanity is coming of age, and each of you must suffer the consequences or reap the rewards of your actions. It is quickly becoming evident which areas of the planet are most in need of cleansing and balancing. We are endeavoring to keep the level of pain and suffering at a minimum and, as you have been told, the mass destruction of your planet is no longer a possibility. However, as is the case when you allow your physical body to deteriorate to the point that your life force is threatened, so it is with the Earth, and drastic measures must be taken. That is why we tell you that these times in which you are now living are so critical. Every opportunity must be taken to assist the Earth to birth and reclaim her light body. That is why we have asked you to come together at the time of each full moon in meditation with the intent of allowing the influx of cosmic life force to flow through you and into the Earth. You must take advantage of each opportunity offered you within the grand design of creation. We ask you to become aware of the wondrous opportunities that await you if you agree to take an active part in the transformation of the Earth and humanity. Many of you are, or are becoming, aware of the importance of the event called Vesak, which occurs at the time of the full moon in the astrological sun sign of Taurus. In the past, it was thought to be only a religious celebration in the Eastern world, however, we tell you it has significance for all the world and all humanity no matter what the spiritual/religious ordination. The word Vesak is derived from syllables and energies which are a combination of sounds brought forth from the higher dimensions. Meditate on this word, use it as a mantra and see what emerges from deep within your consciousness. Allow us to explain more fully the significance of this and other holy events and what they mean to the people of Earth. Within the divine plan for Earth and its inhabitants, it was decreed that during the astrological sun signs of Libra and Scorpio there would be a harvesting via the spiritual hierarchy of all the positive, unconditional love/light energy that humanity has projected out into the world over the past year, and these vibrational frequencies of love/light would be stored in a great pyramid of light or a cosmic storehouse in the higher dimensions to be dispensed at a later time. You see, the love/light energy you project is unique because it is mixed with the essence of the earth and your earthly experiences. When it is melded with the rarefied essence of Creator light, it is much more easily dispensed into the areas of the earth where it is needed, thereby causing less chaos and destruction when the vibrations of light come in contact with the unbalanced frequencies of darkness. It is also more easily integrated and utilized by those who are awakening and receptive by causing less distress and bedlam in their environment as they endeavor to return to balance and harmony within. We have told you that you are the transformers and transducers of the love/light which carry the components of life and all creation, and these waves of light are bombarding your earth in greater amounts and increasing strength. And the wonder of this gift is, beloveds, the more of this wonderful elixir you can contain, the more you can disperse, share with others, and then even more will be given to you. There is a great gathering and celebration in the higher realms, and it is as if each and every soul's good deeds or vibrations of love are weighed and measured, and it is determined what your additional and special share of heavenly gifts will be forthcoming for the next cycle. Your guardian angels and angelic guides will use your special allotment of love/light to create more wondrous miracles in your life in order to open the way, ease the path and assist you in fulfilling your divine mission. Your share of heavenly riches will be bestowed upon you, which you are to use to help create a better world, and to help accelerate the ascension process for yourself and for others. Remember, we have told you that you must learn to receive so that you may better serve and share your gifts and your abundance. The event you call Easter also has a much deeper significance than an observance of the crucifixion and resurrection of the Christ being Jesus/Yeshua. This beloved one set the stage for what is occurring on earth at this time. He opened the way so that the divine love/light of our Father/Mother God and the Supreme Creator could penetrate the veil and eventually permeate the earth and the consciousness of humanity. The vibrational frequencies of light are radiated forth in the greatest measure during the sacred event called the Wesak Festival, which is held at the time of the full moon during the astrological sun sign of Taurus. It is a time of showering down upon humanity and the earth the pure essence of the Creator through our Father/Mother God, the Lords of Light, the Buddhic forces and the Christ beings from the highest dimensions of this universe. These times are especially auspicious, for there are divine representatives of the Creator from throughout the Omniverse stationed in the great cities of light we have spoken about. They have come to observe and to share their unique gifts with humanity during these unprecedented times of transformation and evolution. We ask you to join with your soul families and your companions on the journey in a celebration of love, thanksgiving and unity. To magnify and enhance the integration of the divine gifts of love/light, we suggest that those gathered build a group pyramid of light/power in the higher fifth dimensions, and as you come together in this sacred place, the infusion of Creator Light will be magnified amongst you, and each of you will share and benefit from the gifts bestowed on each other. You will have built a sacred place where, henceforth, you can come and join together with your soul companions and you will receive support, inspiration, and wisdom from your special ascension group. Wherever you are inspired to be, know that it is a commitment you made a very long time ago in the higher realms. It will be a reuniting of star seed groups who have agreed to step to the fore and show the way for the beloved souls who will follow in their footsteps. You are the ones who are preparing yourselves to be the bearers of the Christ/Creator energy foretold as the Second Coming. We have told you that there will not be one great avatar or emissary of the Creator to lead the way into the New Age. Each of you has the potential to be a bearer of the light and a wayshower into the future. The third event we wish to speak of will take place on May 23, 2005. During the full moon in the astrological sun sign of Gemini and has been designated as the Festival of Humanities. You will have begun the integration of the refined frequencies of light that were bestowed upon you during the Wesak Festival, and at this event you will be asked to make a commitment to be an active bearer of light who will radiate forth out into the world the divine frequencies of love/light, wisdom, and power. In doing so, you will help make these wondrous gifts available to those who are stepping onto the path of awakening and beginning their journey toward enlightenment. Many of you have asked or are wondering about the locations of the cities of light in the higher dimensions that we have recently spoken of. Even though we have mentioned a few in the past, at this time, we will not divulge the locations of these portal light cities, for we do not want you to think that one place on earth is better than another. Instead, we suggest that you go into your own pyramid of light and ask that an ascension column be built through and around you, with you as its anchor. Envision the light from your own God self radiating down from the higher realms and permeating your being, and as this light grows stronger it will expand until it surrounds your home, your neighborhood, your city, and will radiate out further and further in the area in which you live. Every area on earth must be cleansed and brought into harmony. You are in or will be led to the place where you can be of the most service, and if you are filled with light instead of fear, you will be safe no matter where you are. Those who need cataclysms to awaken will take their cataclysms with them no matter where they go, for that is the reality they are creating through their thoughts and actions. If your higher self wishes you move to another location, you will be guided and inspired as to when and where you are to relocate and where you can best serve and be served by the light. Some are also asking for more information regarding the gift of four angelic helpers, which I recently reminded you were available to each of you. All you have to do is sincerely ask for this gift, for we will not infringe upon your free will. It will be more effective if you ask during your meditation time, or better yet, go into your pyramid of light, for in doing so you bypass the distortions of the third and lower fourth dimensional mass consciousness. In the sacred environment of your pyramid of light, we can radiate our essence down to you and join you there. Your guardians, guides and teachers are there waiting for you, and you may also call upon any of the beloved beings of light, the masters or avatars or whomever you wish to join you. That is one of the wonders of these times. We can now commune with you once more, and this is the easiest and most effective way for us to interact with you. You can ask to be taken to one of the great cities of light in your etheric body, which will allow you to experience the wonder and the beauty of the heavenly realms. You must be aware that there are universal laws and a protocol that must be followed, as well as rules which determine what your unseen friends can do with and for you. We cannot negate or wipe out the tests and challenges that your higher self has instigated for your learning, however, we can smooth and ease the way if you are in the proper frame of mind and endeavoring to follow the higher path, and we can also dissolve any residual negative vibrations around you once you have garnered the wisdom from a particular lesson. You must always seek your highest good and the greatest good for all others. Your intent is of the utmost importance, and you should always strive to stay centered within your sacred heart, to maintain balance and harmony even in the midst of chaos around you, and live your life with integrity as you follow your highest truth to the best of your ability. Then, beloved friends, we will walk beside you and smooth the way before you as you claim the gift of self-mastery that is being offered you. Let us all join together in the higher realms in these coming months, as we merge our essence one with another, and together we will spread the divine light of the Creator out into the world and beyond. I am ever your faithful companion on the journey. I am Archangel Michael.